In this video, let's talk about how bright should your videos be when you're color correcting them and what is the super white point. This video is part of a series about my simple rules on how to create cinematic images. These rules are like rules of thumb, so they can and should be broken. But these are easy to remember and easy to do, even with minimal or no gear. So let's start. Okay, let me try and explain you what is a super white point by showing you a couple of clips here. For example, this clip. You can see that here's the scope on the right. You can see that even though this image has a lot of contrast, there's no pixels in this frame that are going over the 80% line. Because I have chosen my 80% IRE, this like brightness value, to be my super white point. Even these keys on the piano, which are like as white as something can be, these pixels are not going over the 80% IRE because it's my super white point. But here is this window, and the window is going over, well over the 80% IRE line. And the simple reason is that a simple rule of thumb is that pixels that are not emitting light should not go over your super white point. So you choose your super white point, and then if there's nothing in the frame that is emitting light, then you don't let anything go over the 80% or whatever is your super white point. But if there's light in your frame, then you can let those pixels go over the super white point. The point here is that you kind of reserve the top part of your dynamic range for light sources and bright areas and maybe windows like showing what's happening outside. And this is very common in movies. Let me show you a couple of stills. This is a Blu-ray.com where you can find still images from movies. This is the Taken 2008. And for example, in this frame, you can see that, but this is by the way a tool that you can see the values of whatever is below your cursor. It's this tool, Classic Colometer. It costs a bit of money and it's only for Mac. If you don't want to use any money or if you want to get it for Windows, you can use this. The links are below this video in the description. But anyway, let's continue. So here you can see this brightness value. If I hover over, you can see that none of these pixels are going over the 80%, 80 IRE, but this lamp here is going over the 80% because it's emitting light. And same thing here with this yellow thingy, it's clearly emitting light, so it's just above the super white point. And then here on this this Spectre, this is the movie, James Bond movie's Spectre. For example, this clip here, you can see again looking at these values, you can see that nothing goes over the about the like whatever the super white point is, except these light sources that go to 95, and even here these go to these reflections go to even 97. So there you get the idea. So when you're doing your exposure, like deciding how bright your images should be, make sure that pixels that don't emit light don't go over your super white point. Okay, simple as that. In these clips, I used a color correction kit for the GH5. This is a set of tools for Lumix cameras for color correcting the footage. If you want to learn more about this color correction kit, or you want to learn more about color correcting in general, there's a free course right there, you can go and check it out. I have gotten a lot of positive feedback from that course, so I guess it's good, so then go and check it out. And as I said, this video is part of a series of videos, so now I would recommend for you to check out other videos in this series. And while you're at it, subscribe to the channel and see you in the next video.